asking what is an inverter is not a stupid question. The reality is, unless you have solar experience or very other niched experience like electrical or automotive, most people don't actually know what an inverter is or does. Simply put, when it comes to solar, solar panels generate power. Batteries store your power, and inverters give you access to that power. So welcome back to the lab, where our opinions cannot be bought. Since we started this channel, our goal has been to be a resource for you guys, not just with reviews, but also to help you guys understand even some of the simplest things when it comes to solar. And so today we're gonna give you guys a quick overview of what a solar inverter is, how it works, and how it fits into your system. If you're a visual learner like us, a solar inverter doesn't necessarily look a certain way. It could look like this, it could look like this, it could look like this. At the end of the day, they all do the same thing, which is converting power stored in a battery from DC or direct current over to AC or alternating current so that you can use it to power your devices. Or vice versa, if you're trying to charge your batteries with AC, they can do that job too. So like we already said, solar panels generate power in direct current. Your batteries store power in direct current. Anything that you plug into a regular 120 volt wall outlet in your house uses AC or alternating current. And any of these inverters basically take the DC from your batteries and convert it into AC or alternating current so that you can use it to run all of your gear. Some of the bigger ones, like this guy, also take AC, so the power directly from the grid, from your house, and they can actually convert it to DC and put it into your batteries instead of having to rely strictly on your solar panels putting power into your batteries. Your inverter is often referred to as the brain of your solar setup because it can monitor and manage how power is being used throughout your system. They can do things like take DC current from your panels and put it into your batteries, but it can also be smart enough to recognize if you're running a pretty big load, it can take that DC energy, convert it to AC, and put it directly out to your load instead of your batteries. You can set different priorities. You could be charging your batteries with DC power from your panels while you're powering your loads with AC power from the grid that's passing through it. There's all kinds of different functionality that you can actually tell your inverter to do, aside from just converting from DC to AC or AC to DC. It's kind of like the police officer in the intersection when the power's out. He's standing there directing traffic, telling everybody where to go. That's basically what your inverter does inside of your entire solar setup. So that's the basics. For some examples for you guys, this little Renogy 12 volt inverter does just the inversion. It is the most basic version of an inverter that exists. This is compatible with 12 volt batteries. All it's doing is plugging into your battery right here with two wires and then converting the DC from your battery into AC at these three plugs. That's it. You can't do it the other way around. Doesn't have very much brains inside of there. A very simple unit. Something like this is more common in like a boat, a RV, or a very basic, I don't want to say dated, but like kind of dated off-grid system where you have a separate charge controller, separate inverter, all these separate components. That's kind of the way it used to go down. An inverter like this EG4-3000 is a 48 volt inverter, so it's meant to work with a bit of a higher voltage battery, and it's an all-in-one inverter. So it has your solar charge controller built directly into it. It does the inversion process from AC to DC or DC to AC. And this one's also smart enough to be the policeman in the intersection and make decisions based on the settings and the input that you give it for time of day, preferences, depending on what you're trying to use and that kind of thing. This guy right here is like the bare minimum we would recommend if you're going solar. Something like this has become pretty dated unless it's a very, very tiny setup. An inverter like the FlexBoss behind me does literally everything. It does the DC to AC, AC to DC. It has your solar charge controller built directly into there. It can sell power back to the grid, so it's smart enough to monitor power coming in from your panels if your batteries are full or if you don't have batteries or depending on what you want your system to do. It can then take that power and sell it back to the grid after it converts it to AC to help reduce your power bill. You can have it set up for all the different time of day settings, different power use settings. There's quite literally nothing that an inverter like this cannot do. Smart inverters like these two EG4 ones also have some additional benefits when it comes to your entire system. They allow you to monitor your system and keep track of how much power you're producing, how much power you're using, and track the overall health and efficiency of your system. It helps you to better understand your energy use patterns and also helps you to identify any issues or anything like that directly through the inverter. And the one behind me even has some of the latest technology in terms of safety features like the RSD, which is rapid shutdown, and some other things that will basically just help you protect your investment that you've made, your home, and all the devices that you have running off of it should it sense any sort of of problems with any different part of your system or the grid. So at the end of the day, it's pretty simple. I don't think there's a need to overcomplicate it. If you guys are just getting into all this and you're trying to learn, we have a full educational playlist that we will link in the description down below with a bunch of different content that we've tried to make to help you guys better understand just the bare necessities of solar. Otherwise, make sure you guys are subscribed. That is all we got for you guys today. We will catch you in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.